So we've talked about one policy response to pollution, the idea of a Pigovian tax. And we've talked about the idea that perhaps sometimes, due to the Coase theorem, people will be able to solve their environmental problems on their own. But let me now go ahead and talk about tradable permit systems. So, one way of dealing with an externality problem, say a negative externality problem, is to tax people. And that's a great solution when the marginal external cost is flat and known. Because then we can go ahead and put the tax on there, and that's basically great. But on the other hand, there's lots of things, as I said, where the marginal external tax maybe, or the marginal external cost maybe goes something like this. So, in that case, we're really worried about keeping the amount of pollution under control more. So, we really need to keep it from getting into this really high region here. So, in this case, and let's suppose we have the marginal benefit of pollution here. So we might know that, say, for instance, we need to keep carbon dioxide emissions below a certain amount here. Well, then what we do here is we issue a certain number of permits. Now you'll notice that if we issue this amount of permits, we get to the efficient outcome. And we can see that the permits will trade for this amount here. Because remember, this curve here, the marginal benefit of pollution curve, tells us the gains from trade that can be emitted can be gained from emitting that amount of pollution. And if you can get $30 of gains from trade from emitting that amount of pollution, then you're going to be willing to spend up to $30 to get that permit. So that's one way of thinking about it. And notice, Pigovian taxes and tradable permits can be made equivalent. Or at least mostly equivalent. There is a slight difference here. With Pigovian taxes, we create a situation where the price of pollution is fixed. And so in that case, we know that there will always be some deterrent to pollute, but that deterrent to pollute won't get higher if pollution rises. So there's a known deterrent, known and constant deterrent to pollute. Tradable permits, the quantity of pollution is fixed. Thou shalt not pollute more than the permit amount. So, known and constant quantity. Maximum quantity of pollution. But it may be that in this case, we have an unknown, or it will be the case, the here, if we have a Pigovian tax, we will have an unknown quantity of pollution. Because, say, for instance, if this marginal benefit curve shifts out, or if we're thinking about a supply-demand diagram, it may be true that the Pigovian tax causes the supply curve to shift from S1 to S2, and so it does reduce the quantity of the activity, But then if there's an increase in a demand for the final product, then we get back out to here. So again, known and constant price, but unknown quantity here. If we have tradable permits, we have a known and constant quantity, but we have an unknown and variable deterrent to pollute. Now, all that said, we're kind of getting into a little bit of fine distinctions and splitting hairs. The overall point is that both of these systems, whichever you prefer, can be used to regulate pollution in a relatively efficient way. And so now I'm going to go ahead and stop and talk about inefficient ways to regulate pollution.